restrict plate tracks are a little difficult.
Restrictor plate racing has been a part of NASCAR racing for a long time.
I would describe it as a 200 mile an hour chess match.
It's just a wild atmosphere. You're making reactions to things that you don't even remember.
You don't want to lift, you don't want to break your momentum.
You got to be able to know the draft, understand the draft.
It's a different form of what we do.
There's a lot more that goes into it that you don't have control over.
It's definitely a chess game because you're always thinking three or four steps ahead, and it's tough to get caught up when you make a mistake. You're like, oh, you got to quickly get rid of that and put together a new plan.
Making knee-jerk reaction decisions the whole race.
Block other guys, find holes, make holes.
You need friends, you need people that trust you.
You have to try to gain the track position, keep your track position, and you have to try to fight for that all day.
And at the end of the race, everybody's saving their best for the end, and cars are just going everywhere.
There was moves, reactions, everything. There's so much going on inside the car.
The plan you thought you had, you gotta make a new one. It just, you gotta go on the fly.
The defense has become so much a part of being a good restrictor plate racer. You have to try to anticipate and see when somebody's going to make a move to position your car in front of it so that you can get a good run. So you need help, but you also have to be on the defense a lot.
More years you've been around and have a reputation for getting to the end and being smart, I think is usually a positive.
So you just kind of get a gauge as the race goes on, who's been up front all day, but you gotta keep track of the guys that have been hanging out in the back and they're gonna show up at the end.
You know, you have teammates out there and you need them to get right down to the end. And by the way, now you need to beat them.